dear children, once again I am here with the same chapter, that is from Bihar, lesson number 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind. In last lecture, we have seen about the short summary of this lesson. Today we will see this lesson in detail, that is paragraph wise. So you also open your textbook before you and listen very carefully. Who do you think of when you hear the word genius? Who is a genius? What qualities do you think a genius has? We shall now read about a young German civil servant who took the world by storm about 100 years ago, in the summer of 1905. The age, the 26-year-old published in quick succession for 4 groundbreaking papers about light, the motion of particles, the electrodynamics of moving bodies, and energy. His work took up only a few pages in scientific journals, but changed forever our understanding of space, time, and the entire cosmos, and transformed the name Einstein into a synonym for genius. 50 years after his death, Albert Einstein, genius still reigned. You know, genius, in the last lecture we have seen, genius, extraordinary, synonym, you know the similar word of genius? So here the whole world say, genius is equal to Albert Einstein. Really, the beautiful, as it is said, his mind was beautiful mind. The name of the lesson is also, you know, very beautiful, they have kept. And the whole lesson is also beautiful. As said in the last lecture, I like this lesson very much. I have taken much inspiration from this. And now we go paragraph wise. Albert Einstein was born on 14th of March 1879 in the German city of without any indication that was destined for greatness. On the contrary, his mother thought Albert was a friend to her. His head seemed much too large. Albert Einstein was born on the 14th of March 1879. When he was born, his mother was thinking, this Albert boy is an abnormal boy because his head was too big compared to other children. At the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. When he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. Einstein did not know what to do with other children, and his playmates called him Brother Boring. So the youngsters played by himself much of the time. He especially loved the mechanical toys. Looking at his newborn sister Maza, he said, "Fine, but where are the wheels? Where are wheels?" See, your dear children, when at the age of 2.5, he started speaking means most of the children, generally, children speak at the age of 1 year and 1.5. But he started speaking at the age of 2.5, and that too with very difficulty. And when he started speaking, he was uttering words, each word twice. And he played always with the mechanical toys. And he played always alone, not with the other friend circle. And then his friends called him Brother Boring, because he was always playing alone. When he got, you know, newborn sister, when she was there at home, when he looked at her and said, Where a, what is that? Where are her wheels? You know, everything is there in his mind, all the mechanical things. So when he saw her, he said, where are wheels? Wheels are not there. So the newborn baby, because all the things are there in his mind, the mechanical mind was there. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose, a profession, wouldn't matter because he will never make a success at anything. Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to. He later became a gifted amateur violinist, maintaining his theme throughout his life. Einstein, once his father had been called in the school, and the school headmaster told his father that whichever field Albert go, he will not success in that. He will not success in that. He told his father, but mother taught him how to play violin at the age of 6, and after that he became a gifted amateur. Amateur, what is meant by the amateur? So here somebody is doing for pleasure only. He was playing the violin for his pleasure, for his entertainment. So he was the best violinist, maintaining his skill throughout his life. Fourth paragraph. But Albert Einstein was not about pupil. He went to high school in Munich, where Einstein's family had moved when he was 15 months old, and scored good marks in almost every subject. Einstein hated the school's regimentation and often clashed with his teachers. At the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled there that he left the school for good. Then what happened? And when he was 15 months old, his parents shifted to the Munich. Shifted Munich. And there he has continued his studies. And at the age of 15, he left the school because of strictness of the school teachers. Then he couldn't adjust that strictness with the, he couldn't adjust himself in that school. He left the school at the age of 15. At the age of 15 means near about 8th, 9th or 10th standard. Einstein felt so stifled that he left the school for good. The previous year, Albert's parents had moved to Milan and left their son with relatives. After prolonged discussion, Einstein got his wish to continue his education in German-speaking Switzerland in a city which was more liberal than Munich. After that, he continued his studies in Switzerland, in a city which was more liberal than the previous school, that was in Munich. Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics. He was so clever, so genius in math, but was interested in subject physics. And after finishing school, he decided to study at a university in Zurich. But science wasn't the only thing that appealed to the dashing young man with the walrus mustaches. He also felt a special interest in a fellow student. He's in the university, Meliva Marie, whom he found to be a clever creature. His young serf means what? What is meant by serf? In a person from Serbia. Person from Serbia. Then Malik, whom he found to be a very clever teacher, the young serf had come to Switzerland because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. I think so. That was the only the place where the women get the degree. So the Meliva married had also taken the admission there, and they met with each other in that university. Einstein saw her in alley Anson saw her in her as a friend. Ally is a, means friend. Friend against the Philistines. Philistines means what? Philistines, people not liking. See, the Philistine people not liking the artistic profession. So that is a, saw in her an ally against the Philistines. Those people in this, in his family and at the university with whom he was constantly at odds. The couple fell in love. The couple, these two people, Albert Einstein and Mary were married, fell in love. Letters survived in which they put their affection into words, mixing sighs with tenderness. Wrote Einstein, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work on one relativity to a victorious conclusion. In 1900, at the age of 21, Albert Einstein was a university graduate and unemployed. After completing his graduation, as soon as he completed, he did not get a job. After 2 years, he got a job. Unemployed, he worked as a teaching assistant, gave private lessons, and finally secured a job in 1902 as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. While he was supposed to be assessing other people's invention, Einstein was actually developing his own ideas in secret. Genius people can only do this. He was assisting others, but simultaneously he was doing his work. That is a secret job, whatever he likes that. His secret, he is said to have jokingly called his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. One of the famous papers of 1905 was Einstein's special theory of relativity, according to which time and distance are not absolute. Indeed, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after a journey. If one of them has been moving very fast relative to the other. From this followed the world's most famous formula, which describes the relationship between mass and energy. Between mass and energy, that is, the formula is E is equal to mc square. That is very famous formula. E is equal to mc square, which describes the relationship between mass and energy. While Einstein was solving the most difficult problems in physics, his private life was unraveling. Unraveling, what is meant by unraveling? Starting to fail. Because he got married with Meliva, and after a few years, it was unraveling. You know, so unraveling. Albert had wanted to marry Meliva right after finishing his studies. But his mother was against him. She thought Meliva, who was 3 years older than her son, was too old for him. She was also bothered by Meliva's intelligence. She was also an intellectual personality. So she thought that also. And she was 3 years older than him, Albert Einstein. Intelligent. She is a book like you, his mother said. Einstein put the wedding off. The pair finally married after few years. After few days, they got married in January 1903 and had two sons. But a few years later, the marriage flattered. After those, I think so 16 years of their marriage, that broke it. That is flattered, broken their, weakened their marriage life. Meliva, meanwhile, was losing her intellectual ambition and becoming an unhappy housewife. After years of constant fighting, the couple finally divorced in 1919. Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to world fame. In 1915, he had published a general theory of relativity. General theory of relativity, which provided a new interpretation of gravity. An eclipse of the sun in 1919 brought proof that it was accurate. Einstein had correctly calculated in advance the extent to which the light from fixed stars would be deflected through the sun's gravitational field. The newspaper proclaimed his work, the Nobel Prize, proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution. And Einstein received the Nobel Prize for physics in 1921. He was showered with human honors and the invitations from all over the world and lauded by the press. Everybody praised him, appreciated him throughout the world. And when he got a Nobel Prize for physics, at the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter of urging of his colleagues, all the scientific colleagues, they urged him. They told him about Einstein wrote a letter to the American President Franklin D. Roosevelt on August 1939, in which he warned a single bomb of this type exploded in a port might very well destroy the whole port together with some of the surroundings territory. He wrote this letter, don't make bomb because that may be very, you know, exploited, means surrounding, destroy the whole port together with some of the surrounding territory. His words did not fail to have an effect, did not affect, you know. It was no impact of that letter, even though it's written by Albert Einstein. The Americans developed the atomic bombs in a secret project of their own and dropped it on the Japanese cities Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945. In Nagasaki in August 1945. Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of the destruction. This time he wrote a public message to the United Nations. Public message, open letter. First, before putting, dropping that, you know, bomb, he had written letter, but nobody paid attention on his letter. Then after that, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, he was deeply sorrowed, you know, shaken, and he wrote open letter to them, to public message to the United Nations. In it, he proposed, what he proposed? The formation of a world government. Unlike the letter to Roosevelt, this one made no impact. The letter which he had been written to the president, Franklin Roosevelt, this time also no effect of his letter. But over the next decade, Einstein got ever more involved in politics, agitating campaigning for an aid to the arms buildup and using his popularity to campaign for peace and democracy. He started his work towards the peace and the democracy. When Einstein died in 1955, at the age of 76, he was celebrated as a visionary and a world citizen, as much as a scientific genius. He, after his death, you know, 55, at the age of 76, he was celebrated as a visionary. Visionary, those who see the vision about the future, and that visionary a person who can think about the future, he was thinking about the future, and a world citizen, person who thinks for the benefit for the whole world. So he was thinking about the whole world and the good thing for the whole world. So this complete story about the genius personality, about the beautiful mind, about the Albert Einstein. I hope, dear children, you understood this lesson. I think so. You liked also this lesson very much. Thank you and have a nice day.